Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. If you didn't already know, Rhombus is my best friend. He's great, he's really good at soccer for some reason, even though he's never played, and I want more friends just like him. Exactly like him. It's easy to clone in my world. My animator can just copy and paste and voila, I've got 20 best friends. I am gonna need way more guacamole now. But what if you wanted to clone your best friend? Or even yourself? How would that even work? Cloning is the process of producing a genetically identical copy of a living organism. It can be done on many scales, from replicating basic DNA to a complete genetic copy of a living thing. Scientists have cloned a bunch of animals in the last 100 years, most notably the infamous Dolly the sheep in 1996. Now we've got cloned cows, horses, cats, and dogs running around, and just recently, two cloned monkeys joined the party. This party smells really bad, guys, if we could just clean some stuff up a bit. If we can clone primates just like monkeys, can we do it with humans? The most successful and well-known method of cloning full living things is somatic cell nuclear transfer. Scientists take an ovum from the female of the species they're cloning and remove all the DNA from inside. Then they take the nucleus of a somatic cell, like a skin cell, from the thing they want to clone and insert it into the egg. The egg is then implanted into a surrogate who carries the egg until it's born. Now that scientists have cloned a non-human primate, we're closer than we've ever been to cloning a person. But there's still a ways to go. The success rate for these monkeys was super low, as it often is with cloning. The scientists started out with 127 eggs and only ended up with 2 monkeys, meaning their success rate was only 1.6%. One of the biggest struggles with cloning primates has to do with spindle proteins. They're crucial in cell division and development, and in humans, they reside in the nucleus of an egg. So when the nucleus is removed to make room for the new DNA, those spindle proteins are removed too, making embryonic development that much harder. Say we found solutions to biological issues like this, navigated our way through the complex ethical implications, and successfully cloned a human. Would your clone be just like you? If you're 5'10 with brown hair and blue eyes, maybe your name is Steve, who knows, you'd expect your clone to look the same, right? Well, you may be surprised to learn that your clone would look completely different. Your appearance is based on genes, yes, but it also depends on the fetal environment you grow in, and which genes are turned off and on. Your clone would also be very unhealthy. Many cloned animals suffer from defective brains, hearts, and livers, and immune system problems. In lots of clones, the tips of their chromosomes shrink quicker, meaning cellular aging happens faster than normal too. So your clone could be really sick and die prematurely. Plus, your clone could have a completely different personality than you do. While your personality is based on some genetics, it's also formed through experiences and upbringing. Just because Rhombus is super friendly, motivated, and likes puzzles, doesn't mean his clone would. A Rhombus clone could be mean, dishonest, and hate puppies. So unless your clone had the exact same development and experiences you did, it really wouldn't be you. With all this being said, would you want to clone yourself still? Let us know in the comments section below. Check out the video we did on what would happen if we brought extinct animals back to life. And that's because in order to bring these animals back, scientists need bits of their genetic material that have been salvaged. And sadly, DNA from dinosaurs hasn't survived long enough to be used here. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.